So last night, as I am scripting for today's video, it was going to be on Baltimore has... I got it, Skylar. Baltimore has fallen. Baltimore City implodes. Police force collapses. Only three officers patrolled major district. And then this morning I wake up and I'm like, hey, look, I have something to add to it. And this ship right here, which has been destroying bridges. This wasn't just the first bridge that it destroyed. Through the fire, my thumbnail was going to be like, get out of Baltimore. Well, now you can't get out. This ship, same ship. Look at this. Is this just a quinky dink? The ship that caused the Baltimore Bridge collapse also crashed in a European port in 2016. And I know this could be tinfoil hat, but I feel like I live in a world of everything's tinfoil hat. Hey, why is everyone on my channel getting unsubscribed? Well, if you were to email Google or YouTube, they'll say, well, it's not their fault. Kindly check any possible extensions that could be installed that you're not familiar with. Some Chrome extensions may unsubscribe you to channels without permission. Or it could be your wife. Some wives may unsubscribe you from Jay Bravo because he's obnoxious. Because I am pretty sure when your wife hears... She's like, this guy again? No, please stop. Also, be prepared for May 15th. We got some earnings now. This is where all the truth comes out and then no one even cares. Currently have a 9% growth expectation, right? It's kind of like Apple, which I'll go over Apple today, where I guess iPhones have slumped 35%. I don't know. It's somewhere in my notes. A lot of percent. How's the stock doing? When people still think that PE ratios and all of the jiggly junk really matters. Zero. Wanna know what matters? This right here. This is actually on silver. Oh, we're getting so close. We're coming to the final countdown. Da-da-da-da. It's one of those lines. You gotta break one of them. Either going to make a shat ton of money in silver or I'm gonna lose a lot. What is this stuff? Oh, shoot. I'm drawing. This is not an easy trade, and it's heavy too, lots of it. I have to go to my vault in Baltimore. Oh wait, never mind. Also on silver, if I were to tighten that, like I brought that line that was you have support and resistance, the triangle. Also, if you want to learn how to do this, start with swing trading, then go into my bear market, how to make money going down, then crypto if you want, that's a little scary, and then get to options. You make your digits go 52% higher. This is just on one contract, and it's really easy. I know, if you've ever been confused, my course is amazing. You have two options on market go up. You can buy a call or sell a put, but what about down? Well, you could buy a put or sell a call. And if you're like, wow, it's that easy. Please take advantage of my 80%. Really? Really, Bravo? All your courses? The lowest you've ever had? And my phone just rang and I don't even know what I was saying. Oh, that the cheapest I've ever offered on that 24-hour sale. So start with swing trading. What, at $199? That is stupid. And then you can learn how to do patterns. Like this is Apple. You can even fire your financial whatever they are where they're just like, buy more. Time in the market is always better than timing the market. Look at Apple. Take Apple for example. And then I'll get back to Baltimore. That, which is just crazy. See, I'm like, squirrels are running everywhere. Phone's ringing. I'm like, where are we today? Thank goodness I have a screen. I'm like, oh okay, we're on Apple right now. Look at the middle index finger. That goes back to 2021 on Apple. If you were to have bought Apple in 2021, congratulations. It's the same price. But if you were just to turn on two things, that's it, two lines. Look at the swings. Below the 200, that's the yellow one, you short it. So it swings up. Do you see this? Look. Swings up, it swings down. It swings up, it swings really far down. It swings really far up, down, up, down. And if you were just to turn on my Bravo 9 and swing that, even if you're under the 200, I mean, you're still gonna do good. Each layer you turn on, the more gooder you're gonna be. I mean, imagine if you had an indicator, link in the description, that turns on. See that little purple thing? That's as low as you're going, right there. How about this one? Called that one. Or how about this one? Called that one. Or this one? You still had a little run. That one, spot, daggety dupe. This one, pullback. This one, over and over.
Now you are currently under the 200-day moving average. And if you want to know why Apple popped, it's not because of earnings. It's because you had a 9 count that came on. That's as far as it goes.
Then Bloomberg comes out. It's like, this is why Apple is cratering. iPhone shipments in China fell by 33% in February. This is exactly why the... What, Apple went up today? Almost. I mean, it's zero. It's right above my head. It's at 0.0, okay? It's nothing. But we have a high probability we are going to continue to head lower. Why? We're under the 200. Number one, you got that pop above the 9, and now the pullback. And also, I take the work off of your hands. If you, because you're like, I can't find anything. I just wait for your next setup on your show because I don't have... What is it, like 99 cents? Come on. I actually teach you in my bull market, the first one, swing trade, FinViz. I go all over the place. So, I mean, if you want to waste your time, and then I know you're going to get confused because you're going to turn on the news and you're going to go, let's short the market. You're like, what? I got this itch. Why is the market going up, right? Stop it with all, this is just macro. I tell you that Baltimore has fallen. Baltimore stock go up, right? This is just, I'm sorry. It didn't, and it confuses the dummies and the few that pop over to the channel. They're like, what's wrong with this guy's hair? I don't know. Should I listen to this guy? He's kind of funny, kind of not. Maybe I should Google this guy. Wow, he has a lot of money. Maybe he knows what he's talking about. Nah, don't listen to that interweb stuff. Conference board, consumer confidence. Let's do some macro slides. Revised down for 500 straight months. And thank you, Bloomberg. Looks like all of that red has really, really put a damper on the stock market. I mean, if you have learned anything on this channel that I've been beaten into everyone's heads, stock market, not economy. Don't get confused. Recession, the stock market could double in a recession. It never has. It's always gone down. But who knows? I mean, I never thought locking you down, injecting you with new drugs. I mean, everyone try this new drug from Big Pharma. It's never been tested on anything, but line up. Everyone lined up. I think you're on your 10th and it caused the stock market to go higher. Correlation, causation, don't know. All I do know is get out of the cities, right? This can't be good. I don't know, maybe... Something magical is going to happen. Maybe all the cities will adopt the Build Back Better and they will just become beautiful sanctuaries that we will all want to run. This is just crazy. Baltimore City implodes. This was before it exploded. They got to change that from implode to explode. Police force collapses. I wonder why. Only 3 officers... They're taking over the city. Where do you get your articles, Bravo, from WYPR on Instagram? Okay. You're like, oh, okay. He goes to Instagram. Baltimore City Council. Good job, Council. Passes budget with $22 million cut to police funds. As Baltimore is now facing, I'm not even going to try that word, apocalyptic. Oh, I screwed up at the end. Almost said a naughty word. Levels of policing shortages. Last week, three police officers, say that 5 times really fast, patrolled a whole district of 61,000. So you got 3 covering 61,000 people. Police are now unable to respond to calls. That'd probably be all calls. Any calls, even this one. Assault. When coming in from Twitter, also where I get news, like I have to go everywhere. You try my job.
Citywide, oldest time available on today's date, trolley shift, Southern District. Anyone
interested? Anyone? You don't have anyone. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and squirrels, when criminals figure this out, which if they have the interwebs, they've already figured it out. It's yours. The city is yours for the taking. Now, normal people, humans that are watching this channel, go to your realtor or don't even worry about it. Go to Zillow. Just sell your house and move because it's gonna get worse. It already is. Do you see? Move to a city that you can do your own business. Wash windows. Find a city that has a lot of windows. Wait, I just said city. No, find an area outside of a city that has Windows as state level warning. All states are different. New data shows pockets of weakness in labor market. So if you thought you had a job, well, if you're in this one, that one, that one, that one, you have a exponential rise in that word right there, unemployment. So go here, leave up there, bad, 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 bad. Don't bother coming to Texas. They already have a window washer. And I already told you, he makes about $1,000 a day cash. Now he's expanding. He's hiring people. Shocker. So get in your vehicle, or don't even get in the vehicle. Just walk. You got to go somewhere else. You got to get out of the middle class. You have to get to the 1%. You're getting squeezed out. You're not going to survive. You're definitely not going to be able to retire. Not saying that retirement's, you know, anything to... Let's make it to retirement. Like, you work your whole life, and then 2 years after you retire, you die. You're going to need 12 times as much as they say. Here's the minimum annual income required to be middle class in Texas. Please tell me. Well, I will. $66,000 to be middle class. And then it'll be $100,000, kind of like Hawaii at $83,000 just to be middle class. And middle class is going bye-bye. $83,000 is not enough. And you're not going to be able to do it by having a job. You have to start business. Start business, move money. And check this out. Hey, if you got kids, US cities where a family must make over $300,000 to raise two kids. Well, just don't raise two kids. Then you get a discount. Comfortably, we're going to be exact. $318,406. The $6 are the hot Cheetos that the kids have to have, or hot Takis. Or your wife, that we'll call her a soccer mom. You know what she needs to have? Wine, Chardonnay at night, like a bottle of it. Because you have horrible kids. I mean, she has to drug herself. You enable everything. I mean, if I could just go back in time and tell myself, I probably still wouldn't listen. And then you have me. See, I'm ahead. I think I am. I'm kind of old. I mean, six kids, you know. Two grandkids, another one on the way. That's three. You got 1 foot in the grave. And I've done some things in my life. So maybe some wisdom here. Maybe you want to check, see if you've been unsubscribed. Seven things the middle class, which if that is you, making $90,000 a year, it's not enough. You won't be able to afford in the next 5 years, 4 years, 3, 2, 1. I know this because I have a time machine. I just have to go up a couple years. You now have to pay $333,000 in your taxes, right? And what's our debt to GDP? We're at 150%. It's over. The game's over. It's done. So Janet's just like, oh, here, everyone, trillions. Is it not working? No, Janet, because of we have to pay it back. And now the middle class will not be able to afford. Let me guess. Scott, Brad, child, looks like yours. You know how I knew? Same beard, same teeth. I knew it was yours. In case you wanted to know what the seven things are, family trips or going on any trip, especially expended. A new car. You always have to have a used car. Private school tuition. I just skip that. Really? Home ownership. Real estate. You can't buy a house. Can't have real estate. What else? I see some California healthcare. You won't be able to afford that. Leisure, travel requirement, throw that one out the window. Safe investments for retirees. Oh, and look, traditionally said bonds and fixed assets. Yeah, that one played out really well for me. I would actually be that one. Because my macro friends are like, yeah, you gotta go all in on TLT. I'm like, why? Well, look at all this macro. I'm like, okay, I will do this for the show, even though we're in a head and shoulders pattern. No. Bravo, time in the market is better than timing the market. This thing has been killing me. I mean, it's like Apple, right? Time in the market. It's the same thing. We're still below. We're below the 200. I mean, right? That's what happens when you're like, well, I think I see a falling wedge. It's like, please, God, make this a falling wedge and not a channel. There's a big difference. One is bearish. The other one's bullish. This is bearish. This is bad. But here, I'm gonna make it good for you. Okay, here we go. Here's some TA below the 200. Here's what we can all hope for. I did not think we were gonna do TA on TLT today, But let's just say the TLT, if you could get up there, you gotta get up there, which is probably gonna be above the 200. It is a flag, but it is a flag below the 200. See, get up there, hurry. I mean, this yellow line is like a rocket ship going into the ground. It's like momentum, and it's like, you wanna go back down here again? Learn from my mistakes. Just swing trade, take advantage of the 80% off, in an uptrend. Don't play the macro game. And also, I did say, don't come to Texas. Did I say come to Texas? Actually, start a business. You wanna do this? This is, I'll mute it, because that's, helicopter's really loud. Here's all the solar panels that just got destroyed, wiped out. So come to Texas, repair solar panels, because we have a thing called hail. Also, if you come to Texas, park your car in the garage. Anyways, looks like that Green Deal is really working out. The new Green Deal. I don't know, whatever. The recycle everything kind of stuff. I have electric cars and I don't know, put plugs in cows so they don't fart. So my apologies for squirrels in this episode of Squirrels Gone Wild. Somehow I mix macro with stocks and breaking news. Love you guys. Again, start businesses, move money, and I'll see you tomorrow.